Hello friends, welcome to Green Learner. This is the first video in the series of sorting algorithms. So first, we are going to understand the very simple and easy algorithm, which is bubble sort algorithm. Okay, we will see its implementation in Java also. So let's go ahead and understand what is bubble sort and why it is called bubble sort. What is the input? Input is the unsorted integer elements. I have taken this 97643, which is completely reverse order. We will sort this using bubble sort algorithms. Output will be sorted array, which is 34679. Okay. Now let's understand the algorithm. Okay. So this is our example input. Start from the first element. This is the outer loop. Okay. And then inside that, I'll start this first element again. Okay. Then I'll compare the j plus 1. For the first one, j is equal to 0, then I'll compare this and this element. If it is this one, first is greater than second element, so I'll swap this one, 7 and 9. It is asking me to swap these elements, okay, and else leave as it is. So I have done this, so I'll ignore this step. I have come to this step. Now move to the next step and repeat above two steps. Now I have to compare this 9 and 6. 9 greater than 6, correct. So swap these elements, 6 and 9. Now I have 7, 6, 9. Okay. And I have to compare this with 9 and 4. So 9 greater than 4. So I have to swap it again. So I have 7, 6, 4 and 9. 9 will move to next position. In the next step, I have to compare this 9 and 3. So I'll be having 7, 6, 4, 3 and 9. Okay, so these are the final element after completing this step, first iteration of this one. Okay, so see, the largest element which is there got its position at the bottom. Okay, so what is the next? Now I have to start from the first element again and repeat the above steps, this and this, up to length minus I minus 1. Length means the whatever length it is and whatever steps that I have performed here. Okay, so that last element which has got its position will be at its steps. Okay, so now I have this one. Okay, I have to perform this step again, so I'll compare 7 and 6. So 6 I have to swap it, and then 7 4 I have to swap it again. So I have 6, 4, 7. In the next step, I have to compare 7, 3. So I'll be having 6, 4, 3 and 7. Okay. And 9 is already there. After this step, I have 7 also at its position. Okay. And I have this 3 elements. Okay. I have to repeat this step again. So what will happen? I'll be having 4, 6 and 3 and these two elements. Okay. And then I'll performing 6 and 3. Then 4, 3, 6, 7 and 9, which are already there. And 6 is also at its position now. And two elements left. So 4, 3, we will swap this and we'll get 3, 4, 6, 7, 9, which is our sorted array. Let's go ahead and see this in action by implementing in Java. Okay. So this is the program which I already have created, bubble sort. Okay. So this step is just to take the input from user. So you do not, this is not part of the bubble sort. Okay. It is displaying element. So this method, whatever inside it is part of the bubble sort. This. I have taken this dataset array, which is unsorted array. Okay. This is the counter to count the number of iteration that it has performed. Okay. I have to take two for loops. One is outer and one is inner. I'll start from the zero as explained in the algorithm. And in inner loop, I'll start the first element and I'll go to this step. So this means it is there. To exclude the last element, okay, that will get its position after first iteration. What I am doing, if it is first element is greater than next element, I am swapping these two elements, going this, doing this again and again, okay. And this counter is counting the number of iteration that we are doing while sorting, okay. So this is just simple steps are there. So let's go ahead and execute this algorithm and see. Okay, the program is running now. So it is asking me number of elements. So I'll enter 5 elements. Okay, I'll enter 9, same element that used in example, 9, 6, 4, 3, 2. Completely reverse order I am giving. Okay, before sorting, 9, 6, 4, 3, 2. After sorting, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. So it has sorted the element. Total iteration to perform sorting, it has performed total 10 number of iterations. Number of 10 iterations, okay. So let's go ahead and run it again and give some other random array, which 5 element I'll give again. So I want to 5, 6, 7, 4, okay, and 8. So there are some elements which are unsorted, others are sorted. So 5, 6, 4, 7, 4, 8, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, it has sorted. It is again taking the same number of iteration. If for the same elements, if it is sorted or not sorted, it will be taking the number of 10 iterations. Okay, let's give it all the sorted array. I am giving the 1, 2, 3. Okay, still our elements are sorted, but it is taking at least 10. Okay, so this is the bad scenario. Okay, so we can optimize this algorithm. So let's go ahead and do some optimization. Okay, I can decide whether to it is I have to perform swapping or not. So how I can optimize this? So take this boolean, mark it false. Okay, and inside this swapping where you are doing swapping, mark it true. Let me okay, so what I'll do when coming out of this inner loop, I'm going to check if it swap performed. Okay, if swap is not performed, so inside the inner loop, if there is no swapping, then break this one. Why I am doing this? So in the steps, you see when there is you are doing step by step, when there are no swapping, it means elements are already sorted, okay, and then I can come out of the loop and I'll be sure that elements are sorted. Okay, so let's go ahead and run this one and see how efficient it becomes and how the iterations are iteration numbers are got down. So see the number I am giving the sorted one, 2, 3, 4, 5. So see the total iterations performed reduced drastically. Earlier it was 10, now it is 4, and I am getting this only. Okay, and if you give the reverse one, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you will get the 10 one, because that is the worst case. Okay, and if you give any random one, so you will get the less number of iterations. Okay, so this way I can optimize it. Okay, so that is why in best case its performance is little bit high. Okay, when your elements are already sorted or only some elements are at not proper position. Okay, so this is a small one, so I'll post it in the GitHub and you will get this algorithm. Let's go ahead and see the performance analysis. So this is the worst case performance, order of n square, because there are two loops involved. Okay, and best case performance is order of n comparison and order of 1 sub swaps that we saw. Okay, best case number of elements are already sorted. Okay, so I can optimize that by using boolean variable. Okay, in average case performance, it is again order of n square comparisons and order of n square swaps, and worst case space complexity is order of 1. Okay, let's see the graph. So order of n square goes like this: when you are increasing the input size, the time increases exponentially. Okay, so where and when to use this? This algorithm is simple to implement. We implemented in 3-4 lines actual algorithm. Okay, and then most problems when even compared to insertion sort. Okay, Bubble sort can be practical if input is in mostly sorted order with some out of order element nearly in position, okay, then we can get it sorted in order of n, okay. So when numbers are used, elements are used and they are all in random position, so it becomes very costly, okay. So this is the reference Wikipedia page where I have taken. So let's go ahead and see this. So if you go to this page, there is already a nice graphic GIF which you can see how it is performing the bubble sort. Okay, so you see 5663. You can go ahead and see it completely. So it's very nice to see, and you can get other details here also. Okay, and for the code part, I'll post this in GitHub repository and give the link in description box. You can get there. So in the next video, I am going to show you the insertion sort, which is another simple algorithm to implement. Okay, so till then, play around bubble sort and see it. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.